Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another solo Geese Unleashed on the channel. Today, we're going to be playing as Chromie. On our team day, it's going to be Chromie, Chen, Zul, Zagara, and Alarak. Going up against Tyrael, Chromie, Artanis, Zeratul, and Tracer. I don't know how I end up... I always seem to get a mirror matchup when I'm playing as Chromie. So we're going to be on Haunted Mines, which means it's going to be a lot of close quarter combat, which also means it's not going to necessarily be a good thing for Chromie, but I'm going to be doing my standard Dragon's Breath build. Mainly, I'm just trying to get my final win done on the quest here. I'm not going to lie, I will say that there has been a... may have spent 2 hours or so trying to get a 3-win quest done. It's been about as solo queue as you can probably think, and I have been trying to record all of them as well. Level 1 getting over deep breathing. But let's not focus on that. Let's focus on the positives here. We have Uncle Chen, already positive. Zagara on a 2-lane map, super positive. Going up against Zeratul and Tracer. Easiest matchup for Chromie of all time. I do like myself some Chromie. She is a she's a hero that I didn't necessarily think I'd ever like. Not a bad thing, of course. I do think that Chromie has a she's got a very appealing playstyle to me, and I mean that in the bestest of ways. I was hoping I was going to time that there with Tracer getting stopped by Alarak. There we go. Level 1, by the way, I did go for deep breathing, which is basically as long as we're able to get a as long as we're able to hit the enemy heroes with a Dragon's Breath, eventually that allows us to do a whole lot of damage to them. And I got tagged by Chromie there while I was setting up for my own Dragon Breath. Even turn that around on Tyrael, just barely out of range. Now, of course, as Chromie, you're going to be at a little bit of a disadvantage as far as HP is concerned because she is so squishy. That's why you have to be very, very careful whenever you're playing as her. But if you enjoy mages and if you enjoy skill shots and skill shot heroes, then you will absolutely love Chromie. Almost able to get the complete dunk there on Chromie herself. Now, of course, remember, Sandblast does not actually hit a doesn't actually hit any creep. Only Dragon's Breath can actually deal damage to creep. Level 4, I did go for Enveloping Assault, which is going to increase the radius of Dragon's Breath, which is very important for landing the Deep Breathing talent. Now, I do know that Zeratul is around here somewhere. I can't really reliably go out too far without getting picked off by him. So I'm basically going to hang out here and... oh, Zeratul is actually up top now. I'm still going to be careful, though. Hoping that I could get Chromie to sit there, but didn't happen. Gonna wait till I get the regen globe there from Uncle Chen, and I'm gonna head on down. Again, very mindful that the enemy team does have a they do have a Zeratul on their team. It's good. I'm glad you're learning, Tracer. She's learned from my tricks. You see Zeratul down there along with the other Chromie. I'm going to see if we can sneak a cheeky little snipe here. Oh, that was not in range of Chromie, huh? A sand trap actually saving Chromie for a second there. We didn't get the bone prison from... Really, it didn't go off? I should be able to get the snipe here with Chromie, though. Or not. I can't believe that Chromie escaped out of that. Chromie should have been dead there. If my time trap hadn't caught her, she definitely was dead. So I'm basically going to rely on Chen for a little bit of support here. I do see Zeratul right there. At level 7, I did go for Mobius Loop, and Mobius Loop is... basically going to reduce the mana cost, but also reduce the damage a little bit, but it also reduces the cooldown, which is a big part about what I like about the Dragon Breath build. I'm trying to see where Zeratul's at. Tracer did stay. She did go back up top. I'm actually going to hearth back. Just go heal. I saw that sandblast from Chromie. I was making sure that she wasn't going to try to land a counter snipe there with Dragon's Breath. Duel and Alarak pushing down the bot lane. Not necessarily the smartest thing I've ever done coming down here, but I'm going to see if I can help Uncle Chen. Nice swap there by Artanis. Yeah, I'm just going to deuce on out as we don't have anyone coming down to help out. Not right now, anyway. So 4.5 minutes, 4-6. Pretty low scoring game despite how much damage both teams currently acquire, or currently have, I should say. I'm looking forward to hopefully taking down Zeraful with a Chrono Warp. Oh, definitely Slowing Sands is pretty tempting on this map, especially considering how close everything is. Apparently Uncle Chen's gonna go after them over here. Uncle Chen's actually beating Artanis. Coming down here. I am gonna go for Temporal Loop, however. Alright. Good job by crazy Uncle Chen. There we go. I am a big fan of Temporal Loop, though. It is a it's a little bit more finicky to land. It's harder to combo because it is a wombo combo. You have to R and then wait for your W and then E. Yeah, like you have to offset it. It's a little bit tricky, but if you can pull it off, though, man oh man, is it satisfying, and it does of course a lot of damage. I mean, that's just Chromie's MO. Take care of some of the creep, and then we're going to defend against the enemy team's golem down here. Really? Crazy Uncle Chen just doesn't even care about running to the stun. I kind of admire that. That's what we like about Crazy Uncle Chen. He wouldn't have had that moniker if he wasn't crazy. Almost fell asleep on that one. There we go. So we only lost the gate and the turret, not that bad. I should be able to help Zagara push down the bottom fort here. As the enemy team is struggling to deal with the pushing prowess of Zagara. I do love playing Zagara. Zeraful is right behind us here. There's the 1-2. Oh, Zeratul able to get the warp away. By warp, I mean the blink. I was expecting the hit coming in from Chromie. That is one of the downsides, though, to Temporal Loop, is that if you go up against someone who is like Tracer or like Zeratul, if they're precise with the timing, they can get out of the way right before your Dragon's Breath lands. Comes the distortion field there from Artanis, so able to land the 1-2 combo on his backside there. Getting torn up by this stupid sapper camp though. Gonna go tap the fountain real quick. Level 11 here. Gonna be going for Reaching Through Time, which is not usually what I would say is the best choice in a game that does feature a Zeratul and a Tracer. Normally you want to go for a timeout. Timeout keeps you safer. Reaching Through Time is definitely a little bit greedier, but one thing that is nice about it is the increased range of the of Sandblast and of Dragon's Breath. You can really get those quintessential Chromie snipes that everyone loves to do, which is my favorite part about Chromie. There you go. Nice job with the setup there by Zagara. I do see Zeraful coming around the side over here. Again, that time Zeratul is still too quick enough to get away, or quick enough to get away, I should say, from the wombo combo. Slay the undead and claim their scroll. I know what you're saying. You're saying, Invicta, just stop trying to go after Zeratul with that attack and you'll be fine. You wouldn't necessarily be wrong. But I like a challenge. I like a good challenge. Heck, if I didn't like a good challenge, I wouldn't be doing solo queue silliness for so long. Am I alright? Yeah. So that's the most I guess, up-to-date commentary I can actually offer right now in this episode. There we go. I don't actually know if there's another skull down there or not. Make sure you always get those time traps down. You want to keep yourself safe. And also remember, you're not just keeping yourself safe, but also your teammates safe. So I think Zagara and I can probably sneak one more camp here before we're going to have to skedaddle on out. I'm just going to deuce on out of here. I'll help Zagara take down the camps, and yeah, basically do what I can. Remember, Chromie cannot hit anything with her Q other than other heroes, so I think it might be a little bit OP if she was able to actually deal that much damage with Sandblast to, especially a piercing shot at that, to enemy creep and that sort of thing. Point Prison used by Zeratul there. I was able to land it on Tyrael. Trying to get it on I don't know where Stitches came from. On Tracer, whatever her name is. Down he goes. Now, unfortunately, that does use the cooldown of Temporal Loop. Zul got killed by the Archangel's Wrath. Somehow we actually ended up taking Grave Golem down the bot. I don't know how we managed to do that. Anyway, going back to a point of what I was talking about with the time traps, you're not necessarily just throwing that down to save yourself. You're also doing it to possibly help out a future teammate problem, if you can. And that's why it's important. That's why I like about Chromie. She is a little bit more versatile than some people may realize. You just think, oh, she's just a combo mage. You know, she's got no HP. She's not really going to be all that useful, other than just being a damage cannon. Oh, this is juicy right here. That's juicy right there! Immediately taking them both down. So good. Level 16, or level 13, rather. No, level 13. 16, whatever. Look, it doesn't matter. Gonna be going for Quantum Overdrive, which is basically like a increased spell power every 30 seconds that I want to by 20%. It's very, very good. That's where the combo really starts to shine. As long as you can land the Temporal Loop into the Dragon's Breath, into the Sandblast, within that short amount of time span, you're going to find yourself dealing tons of damage. I'm going to tap the fountain right now before the fountain goes down to the Grave Golem here. Make sure I get out of the way of that root. And we should be able to easily... Oh, man, I was really trying hard to make sure that didn't happen. Scrolling all the way down here in the bot. Zeratul throwing out the Void Prison. Again, I'm not sure if that's helping or hindering his team yet. Haven't decided. Oh, man. Tyrael somehow got off Eldruin. I don't know how he did that. Again, remember, I'm going to be teeing off here with Quantum Overdrive. I actually landed it right on Chromie, too. Still landing it on Chromie. Oh, man! I thought for sure that last one was definitely going to hit Chromie there. Still have not finished our deep breathing quest yet. We end up getting wiped out. It is possible that we pushed a little bit too far forward there. Losing Zul early on definitely hurt our cause down in the bot lane. Hoping Zul helps me take the Sapper Camp here. You saw that with just one, just simply like one, two. Whoa, okay. I don't know what Zeratul's thinking here. I don't know what that was supposed to do. I knew I saw the shimmer, but I wasn't expecting him to blink in there. So I'm gonna queue up Quantum Overdrive here. Big damage on Artanis. Unfortunately, I missed the Sandblast. Might be able to get a follow-up one. Not quite. I was badly mistimed by myself. I admit to that. I'll own it. I own my mistakes for the most part. Sometimes there's some instances where you just really can't help missing a shot or two. For the most part, Your timing's down. My timing isn't the greatest right now in this Chromie game. I will admit that. Oh man, got a huge damage there on Tracer. You saw her just get on out of there. She panicked, man. I'm gonna use Quantum. Almost killed Zeratul outright. It's fun to watch them freak out whenever we start landing those big shots from Chromie. I see Tracer positioning herself. She's acting like she wants to try to get at me. It's the sandblast on her, but again, this fight's still going on. I'm missing my snipes left and right now. Usually I do have deep breathing done by now. Right on top. Almost got Artanis. That's what I was aiming for. Again, just sieging them from afar. From Jafar. Out. I saw that one coming. I was hoping that Zagara was going to be able to get out of the way. I did like that little flip she did, though. Enemy team getting one back on us here. 15 minutes, 30 seconds down, 16 to 22. Time trap able to catch Tracer again. We're going to stick with Crazy Uncle Chen for now. But the enemy team has not lost anybody yet. Not yet, anyway. Level 18, going to be going for Loophole, which is going to hit multiple heroes on the enemy team anytime I use Temporal Loop. Like that. I actually landed right on top of Zeratul. I didn't even know he was there. Again, I'm just teeing off here. Oh, Alarak, you're killing me, man. Oh, Alarak, you screwed me. Well, at least Alarak escaped. Oh, man, I had that one teed up, ready to go. I believe that's our first death, yeah. Our first Chromie death is unfortunate. For some odd reason, we vacated the mines. I'm not quite sure why. They had a really good advantage there with the enemy team taking a lot of damage early on from me and Chen. But the rest of our team just chose not to go down there. But we're still bullying the enemy team out of both lanes right now as they're about to lose their top keep. And the bottom keep's also not faring that well either. So 16 to 24, the enemy team's been killing us a lot more. Zagara has 8 deaths. Oh, man. Of course, it's never over in solo Caecilius. Never give up, never surrender. Also, never plan on winning. At least, it doesn't matter how ahead you are. If you think you're really like in an unlosable position, the answer is you're not. Don't ever think that you're in an unlosable position in Heroes of the Storm until the game is over. Solo Caecilius, like, that's pretty much like church right there for us. I'm gonna wait for Tracer over here. I'm also waiting for Dragon's Breath to come off cooldown, and then we're gonna go right after her. Pull anyone that we can along with her. Almost got Tracer there. Man, she's landing those rewinds there very nicely, unfortunately for me. As soon as I get deep breathing done, we'll be in a much better spot here. Ah, I didn't get to tap the fountain. Deep breathing, by the way, when you are done with it, it increases the sight rate and also deals an additional bonus damage of 150, which is very nice against heroes. Again, it's predicated on you using it on a hero that can't actually get out of it. Like Tracer and Zeratul. Our golem, unfortunately, didn't do anything this time around. But their golem also didn't really do all that much. Any team does, they do have their level 20s, though, so we do need to be very cautious about how we approach this next team fight. I don't have Temporal Loop up quite yet. I did use Quantum Overdrive here. Zagara ended up going for the Maul. We are able to take down Zeratul. Not gonna lie, I didn't mean to hop into the Maul or the Void Prison there. Almost got Tracer. I'm gonna get a snipe on Tracer. Or die trying. Lots of damage on Chen. With Zeratul not being here and Tracer being a little bit hurt right now, we don't have too much to worry about. Other than getting sniped from Chromie, of course. Theratool's down for another 20 seconds here. Whenever I play Chromie, I like to throw out those little random traps here and there. Again, it's not necessarily about preserving yourself, but it's also possibly saving a teammate in a fight that they may not be expecting. Here comes Artanis. I do see Tracer and Tyrael up at the top. We can't afford to give up this fort for free. I got swapped there by Artanis, and I'm just going to die immediately. As out of nowhere, the entire enemy team but Zeratul came out there, and we're just going to give up that fort for free, which is something I really don't really agree with. There's the Maw trying to save Zagara, but Zagara's going to die again. And down goes Alarak, and down goes Chen. So, Yep, good old insurmountable Sogusilinus lead. 30-17, our Zagara's died 10 times. Not exactly ideal, although she is number one in hero damage. Which is pretty impressive for Zagara. But, yep. Game, of course, is not over yet. But they just got a hard ace there. I really don't feel like we should have given up that top fort for nothing, but, woo! So the enemy team is going to have a 100 Skull Golem, and with nothing to stop it from going straight to the core here. That's going to be bad news bears for Team Solo Q, Mid Silliness 9, LMQ, Copenhagen, Wolves, Toys R Us, Hadway, Toasty, blah, 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 blah. Sorry about this. Like I said, you never, ever, 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 ever are in a safe lead in Heroes of the Storm. I mean, the game is designed around that premise. We're going to have to hold on to these siege or not. All right. Normally, you want to not cap the siege giants until the boss is, like, headed down towards the giants. So you can get, like, some defense on them. Okay. Okay. I have no idea how Tracer didn't get killed there. That time trap that I threw down, though, I was for sure banking on Dragon's Breath hitting before that time trap went off. I almost killed Zeratul and Tracer outright, and where everyone else was, I'm not exactly sure. They're gonna try to, like, get some skulls, but honestly, this is not going to matter. Alright, we got 4 skulls. Alright. And we're going to lose everyone else to not have a defense. So, final total is going to be 34-17. Oh, yep. Got another one of these games. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And, yeah, as always, let me know what other heroes you'd like to see here in Solo Queue Silliness. I'll put the link down below to the build. We were able to finally get deep breath, deep breathing, whatever you want to call it. And, yeah, it's good. Good week of Solo Queue. Woo!
Your spirit will find its way back soon. Do not let death defeat you. Use it and take revenge. The enemy is attacking our core!